In this tutorial, I'm again going to create a link between a database and Visual Basic. But in this tutorial, we're not going to use any toolbox items, we're just going to use code. So before I start, let's have a little look at the hospital database that I'm going to use. Now, I've used this in school and it proved to be a very successful tutorial, so I'm going to use it here as well. There are two tables, as you can see here, one holding details of patients and one holding details of wards. And there's also a query here that combines details of the patients and the wards that they're in. And if anyone's interested how I managed to do that, it's in my relationships. If you, in Access 2010, go to Database Tools, you can see in here that there is a relationship between this data. Now, if you need to know more about this, I've covered relationships in a previous Access tutorial. We're not going to discuss that now. All you need to know is that there are two tables and one query that combines the data of both of those. Now then, how do we import this into Visual Basic? Well, first of all, open up Visual Basic, start a new project. I'm going to call it Hospital. And click on OK. And then you start in the familiar Visual Basic window. Now, what I'm going to do first is add a data grid and three buttons on the screen. So I go down to General and select my data grid. If you can't see it here, don't worry, just go to Tools, go to Choose Toolbox Items and find it in here. It'll add it to the toolbox then. And I go to Data Grid. I click and drag a data grid in the screen. Now over on the right hand side here, I give this a name. I'm going to call it Grid, GRD, Hospital, like so. And then I'm going to create three buttons underneath. The first button is going to pull the wards details out. So I name that button wards. And in the text, I change that to wards. In the next button, I'm going to get the patient's details out. So create a button, change the text to patients, and go up to the name and type in btn button patients, like so. And then finally, the final button will pull the details out of the query. So I create that button on screen. Don't worry if it's not the right size, you can correct that later. I'm going to call that button patients and wards, like so. And then go down to the text and change that to patients and wards. And there's the bare bones of my form. I'm also going to change the name of the form by clicking on the form itself. I'm going to name, sorry, going to text, not name. I don't want to change that. I just want to change the text, and I'm going to call that hospital details, like so. So that's the table ready to go. Now we're going to start the coding. But before I do that, I want to move the database into a location that the program here can access it readily. So I'm going to save all for now, my project, and I call it hospital, and click on save. And now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to go back to my desktop, I'm going to go to my documents, and I'm going to navigate to the folder, projects, hospital, go to the binaries folder, the bin folder there, and go to the debug folder here. And what I'm going to do is drag a copy of my database into this library. And it's got to be in here for one of the lines of code, one of the chunks of code to work. So make sure you do that. And back to Visual Basic. Now I'm going to start on the code. So the first thing I'm going to do is create a load of variables that will handle the database connection. So for what to do, first thing, double click on the form. And it'll open up in this view. Now, before public class form one here, I want you to type in imports system.data.oledb. Now, this will save you a lot of time when you're coding later on, you'll see now. Now, next, under public class form one, I want to, in here, create all my variables. Now, I'll just pause for a second while I do that. And here, I've created a load of variables that act as, first of all, a database connection, a database command, a data adapter, and the connect string. Now, for this connect string here to work, where I've actually pointed out where to go for the name of the database, for this to work, this line here, you have to have made sure that you move the database into the debug folder inside the binaries folder. So that's me now set up the connection, the command, the adapter, and so forth in here. I'll just stop for a second to have a little look at that. Next, I want the button, the wards button here, to pull the data out of this database. So I double click on the wards button and I type some code in here in the button wards click. So I'll just pause while I do that. And here's my code that will make the wards button work. The first line here connects you to the database, forms a new database connection with the connect string up here, the hospital details MDB. Then the data adapter is created and the data table is created. The next line tells you that the command object that's going to fill the table is the wards table, and you can see the wards here. It then, this line, select DB adapter, select command, DB command, this sets the data adapter to the table wards. This line then, on the next line clearly does the same, the next line opens the database connection. The fill command here pulls data into the data table. The hospital data source, DT Hospital, this then fills the data grid using the data table from the previous line. And then finally, the database connection is killed. It's closed. So let's run that now and see it work. So if I click on now wards, you can see it pulls the data from the ward in here quite nicely. So I'll just stop that for now. Now that's one way of doing it. There's an easier way of doing it from this, and I'm going to show you this now with the patients button. When I click on the patients button, I want the patient details to come up on screen. So I'll double click on the patients button now, and I'll pause again while I create some code in there. And here's my code. Here's the easier way of doing this. I just set a new data table, use a little query here to pull data into the data adapter from patients, which you remember was the name of the other table, the patients table. The data adapter then pushes the data into the data table in this line. And then finally, the data table pushes the data into the data grid. So you've got a really simple situation. You create a data table, SQL pulls the data into the data adapter, the data adapter pushes data into the table, and the table pushes data into the grid. Let's try that now. Wards does what it did before, and patients, as you can see, it's pulled all the details of the patients into the database, like so. Now I could very easily just strip this code out here, use this code instead, but obviously instead of using patients here, I change the word to wards, and it would pull the ward data out here. Try that if you want to. If you prefer this method, by all means use this method. But of course you will have to have had set all these out in the first place, or it won't work, because as you can see, these use the variables I've set above here. And finally, how to get the query button to work. Well, what I'm going to do here, I'm going to use a data set instead of a data table. Virtually no difference to the eye, but I'll just take you through it now. Double click on the patients and wards, and once again I'll pause while I create the code in there. And here's my code that'll pull the data out of the query. Now you can see it's very, very, very similar to the code up here, but as you can see here, I'm using a data set rather than a data table. Now there are two main differences you can see here. First of all, I haven't defined a data table in this code, but these are the really two important bits. I have set the object DB command here to query patients. Now you've got to change that. And finally, I've made sure the data member properties down here has been set as the query patients. It's not just the data table that I defined in the previous bit of code. So you've got to change this line and this line. These are the two primary main lines that you've got to change. Of course, there are other subtle differences as well. Now let's look at that in entirety. I run it. You can see the first button pulls the details from the wards. The second data button, details of the patients, and finally, patients and wards, it pulls the details of all the data linked into the table. And that's it. Sorry it's a bit rushed. It's quite difficult getting it under 10 minutes for YouTube, but there we are. It's the final look at the code for you. Setting all the variables at the top. First button, complex method of getting data out of a table. Second, the simple method of getting data out of a table. And then finally, pulling data out of a query into Access, and sorry, into VB from Access, and we're done.